Hello. Are we alive? Are we here? Hello, everybody. We got both the boys on screen today. That means it's gonna be a extra long weekend. That's what that means, technically. It's like the Poxatunny Phil seeing his shadow. You got two boys on screen, you get an extra long weekend. I don't make the rules, dude. But what's good, everybody? Ladies and gentlemen, bitches, welcome back to the stream. It is Friday. It is a... honestly, been kind of a long-ass week. I feel like this week has just crawled by. Hey, Renex2305, thank you for joining the fam, subscribing with Prime, dude. Fuck yeah, man. Thank you so much. Kaloha25 says, how's the hair journey going? Should we do a little hair update? I haven't filmed the video yet for the second channel, but I know I told you guys that I was going to. I'm still going to do it. But let's see. I got a haircut today. I actually went and got a fresh little fade, a little taper fade here, taper fade there. But you know, as of right now, I had the beanie on, so it's kind of looking like shit. But out the shower, dude, looking pretty solid, man. Looking pretty good. I can see the thickness coming in, like. I don't know, because it's kind of hard for me to, like, see the camera, but, like, I can tell that there's, like, long hair, and then I can tell that there's, like, very incrementally tiny, teeny, eeny, beeny, weeny hairs, and I feel like when those eeny, beeny, teeny, weeny hairs start to grow longer and longer, it's going to give that thickness, or that illusion of thickness, so, yeah, you know. I'm showering, you know, with my special shampoo. I'm taking my pills every day. I'm doing all the things that I should be doing. So hopefully, you know, come September, October, I'll be slaying and we'll get the thickness. Let me see. I think I might have messed up this focus. Sometimes that happens when we zoom in. I wouldn't say the progress is insane, but I can definitely, like, confidently say at 4 months and, like, a week or some change, I have a hairline, which is levels beyond what I used to have. So far, worth all the hassle. definitely suggest. But anyways, what have y'all been listening to? Has anything dropped this week? I feel like we do have a couple that we need to go through. I have some more friends that I would like to show you as well. So that'll be kind of fun. But, you know, we're just kind of vibing today. I have the Paramore video. It is being a little tidied up slightly in the editing room. But you should be happy to all know that Reputation is dropping this weekend on YouTube. Yes, it is dropping. It's coming in. If you want to see it early, it's on Patreon. Check it out. Drinking out of my wife's bridal cup. Boom! Reputation. Honestly, if you're not part of the Patreon and you want to be, it's a really good time to, because we're doing the tour next as well. So you're going to get, like, all of this, like, Taylor content for this next, like, month or so. It's gonna be fun. It's gonna be a good time. And then you get the Discord too, which is pretty dope. And then all of our other concert series. Like, we went to the 1975, we went to Harry's house, we watched the Folklore Evermore little Long Pond sessions. But, you know. But if you can't, you know, do it, no problem. It's all good. Eventually, all that stuff is probably gonna end up on YouTube sometime or another. So, no worries. I'm doing good though today. Thank you for asking. Appreciate that. R D Pierre. Yes, request away. Request away. I do have some. I'm gonna turn this. I feel like I'm giving them free promotion with my 96 viewers on Twitch. Yo, what the fuck? Meg gifting the tier one sub? Hell yeah. And now we got Vladimir the meme. Vladim the meme. Welcome to the freaking channel, dude. Thank you, appreciate that. We have listened to the new Niall Horny song. That was last week. It's up on Patreon right now. We had a whole experience with the sun, who now today is nowhere to be seen. It's cloudy as fuck up here in Atlanta. Has the weather been shitty where you guys are at? I feel like this week was just all doom and gloom. I was like, shit. It's fucking sad out here today. It's gloomy as shit. I feel like maybe we should hit on some like sad songs, or should we kind of... I feel like we might have some bops, honestly. Might have some bops, but... No, we can always get sad. I know Gracie's sad. I know Gracie's sad. I know. I see all you guys who are like, Gracie's whole album dropped today. You gotta do the Gracie Abrams album today. I've kind of been fucking up these last few weeks saying that I was gonna go live on Saturday, and I just have not been. Just because I've been working, busy, editing and stuff. But I feel like now that I kind of don't have an edit to do, maybe I can go live. I really, though, like, honestly, like, truthfully, I really want to do the Caroline Polachek album. I really want to do that album. I've heard such good things. I heard the first song on it, and I was like, oh, shit. Oh, it's going to be a good one. So I really want to, really, really, really want to do that one. So we should probably do that one first. Probably should. And I'm waiting for the Renee album, dude. I don't care about the deluxe EP releases. We already listened to her. She's up on Patreon. But I want an album from her. I want to see the first album. I'm not going to be listening to EPs over and over again. Yeah, I know. New songs. Dude, it was 70 degrees in Ohio yesterday, and now it's in the 30s. What the fuck? What? No. Take it back. Oh, and the Rebecca Black. I know. Fuck me. I just can't keep up, man. I can't keep up. I need to. I need my inspiration. Where's my boy? Here we go. Right here. Mr. Fantano. Give me motivation to be the busiest internet nerd, or the second busiest internet music nerd. Jesus. I need help. Snowing Wednesday in Pennsylvania. Okay, this is becoming the Weather Channel now.
Snowing in Minnesota, literally 6 feet overnight. We got a 31 degree high and a negative nine.
Oh my God. Holy shit. Yeah, we have new Halsey. Holy shit, Michaela just subscribed with Prime too. Fuck yeah. Let's go, dude. Yes. Thank you for that. Fantano hates Reputation. You know what? I get it. Lower your expectations if you're waiting for the YouTube drop. there might be some ones that you might have to fight me on. I'm not gonna lie. Shan Henderson with another Prime, dude. Are you freaking kidding me, bro? Gosh, you guys are running to the subscribe button. Appreciate that one. Okay, Reputation is your favorite album. See, I feel like that's also a little concerning because I'll just tell you right now, it's not her best. It's definitely not her best album. It doesn't even come close to Red. It doesn't even come close to Reputation. Reputation is what I mean. I mean, hey, did it click? Did it not click? I guess you're just gonna have to wait and see, dude. Whoa. Guess we'll just have to wait and see. Or get the Patreon and get it early. You never know. Nina, I'm not telling you shit, dude. Reputation is over folklore, in your opinion? That's a choice. Definitely a choice that you made. Not me. No. Not me. But you did that one. I'm thinking about dropping the Reputation video on the channel probably this weekend. Probably either like tomorrow or Sunday. I don't know. Feeling quirky. Don't know. Don't really know. And we got a hype train. XV Nunez 14 as well. Subbing with the freaking tier one. Thank you, dude. Appreciate that. Well, we should probably get into some tunes today. Shan't we? Shan't we? Shallent we? Shall we? Or sh. We shall see. We shall see. We shall on the display today. Oh, God. Who am I scrumdiddly umshilling up today, dude? We have a little bit of something, something from the Joe Bros. Okay. Been waiting for this one, folks. I just, if I don't spit all over myself with excitement, because it's Johnny Motherfreaking Bells, dude. Johnny Bellione has been in the producing seat for these boys. I saw little glimpses of it on Twitter. I saw little images on Instagram peeking into the production process. Oh my gosh. My nose itches so bad. Oh, I swear I'm not picking it. I promise. Oh man. But I saw John also working with our girly, incredible vocals, would literally slay if she wouldn't stop singing her campfire songs. Tori Kelly, dude. Yes, Tori Kelly, bro. Love that girl. John's been working with her as well. And, yeah, can't really wait to see what they've been working up with the Joe Bros, though. This song is less than 2 minutes long, though. So not giving us a whole lot for this album. Is it gearing up towards an album? Chat? Fill me in. You don't know who Tori Kelly is? Whoa, hold on. Wait a minute. Y'all need to let me know. I need to know. Who has not heard of Tori Kelly versus who has heard of Tori Kelly? Because we might need to go on a little adventure together just to kind of, you know, refresh the old brain. Known Tori for ages. Okay, that's what I thought, dude. That's literally what I thought. She's literally one of the OG-est YouTube cover people, like musician people. I feel like she's up there with like Justin Bieber, honestly. Iconic. Very excited to hear what her and John have been cooking up, but also excited for this Joe Bros. It's called Wings. It's a minute and 59 seconds, so not even 2 minutes long. Is this gearing up towards an album? I don't know. Probably. I just saw my friend Sarah get invited to the Jonas Brothers Las Vegas show, like party kickoff thingy, something like that. I don't know. It looked fun as shit, and I was mad because I wanted some fucking tickets, dude. Where's my tickets? Come on. I know I'm not quite as iconic as Sarah. She's pretty epic sauce, dude. But without any further ado, let's get into Wings. Jonas Brothers, produced by Mr. Johnny Bellione. Let's see if I can tell. You are the one the sun can light a day. Ooh. You are the wings I need to fly. Oh, I can hear the pocket. Give me love, I feel it. I feel like I ran through the ceiling. Wait. The ceiling. No, my love, it never had a meaning. Oh, meaning. You gave me your reason. You got me believing. this like 80s Phil Collins energy. That's it. I feel like the peanut butter baby. That's all I can say, dude, is that felt magical. Explanationist, dude. I feel like I need to make like a wizarding spell just to like signify how that made me feel. Holy shit, bro. Oh my God. That was fire. What was all the little syncopation? Oh, and the vocals going crazy. This is, I feel like I might need to actually run this back. Echoing in both of the ears, they give it up, they're gonna give it up. Production has really like brought them to like in a whole new level. God damn it, Johnny Boy. Yeah, and this like little building, oh, the bin and don't bin, the 4 to the 5 to the 6, it just keeps on getting higher and higher. Feels so good, dude. Feels so good. Another hype train's coming in. God damn it. Oh, the little syncopation, Oh, I can almost tell when there's like some really like feel good, fast, like flowy. Oh, it's just hard to explain, but like it's that kind of shit that's like, oh, that's John. That's a little bit of John in there. I can tell. He's trying to fit in that little percussive moment with the vocals. It fucks so hard. Oh my God. And then this massive major chord just feels like I'm busting a fat nut. What was the 8-bit? Oh my God, 8 bits all coming out of my fucking veins, dude. Holy shit. Oh my God, they fucking Owl City head ass. Oh, and then the beat comes back in. Throat fucking choke me. That's fucked up, dude. I hate them that's so short. Why is that not even 2 minutes long? Oh, it feels so good. It's probably because it's like all this excitement and they can't really. It's hard to capitalize off of like two massive builds for like hitting that chorus twice sometimes. Sometimes hitting it just one time, it fits, dude. And honestly, it kind of gets replay value too, so kind of tight. Yeah, it's only like 4 minutes when you play it twice. Just playing it twice is like, you know, how long it should be. Oh, man. Oh, that's so good. I do kind of love how Fantano has this whole like genre of like, oh yes, the eloquent this, the subpar that, and I'm over here just like, holy shit, that was really good. That was like really pretty good, dude. Anyways, moving right along. Wait, first of all, Wings. I feel like I need to look up the lyrics to this. I want to know. Are we flying away? Is that what the song is about? flying away. It kind of feels like you're flying when you hit that massive chorus moment, a big old major chord. Yes! Oh my God, this was produced not only by John Bellion, but also The Monsters and Strangers, Pete Nappy, Ten Rock, and The Diner. Wow, that's so dope. Also, Clyde Lawrence from the band Lawrence has a writing credit on this. Exciting! I love that they're still doing stuff with John. That's awesome. Super talented man. I saw him talk about the whole Ticketmaster fiasco. Oh, wait a minute. John is even in the verse. Wait, John's doing background in the verses? Oh. You know, I thought I fucking heard another voice in there. I was like, wait a minute. Is that Kevin? No way. No way. Kevin can't fucking sing. He probably can. He probably can. But it just felt like there was a little something extra. But okay, so Johnny Bells is in the song, literally in the song. Is it featuring him? I guess not. He's not the kind of guy to do a feature like that. Kevin can sing. See Nina coming to his rescue already. I have listened to Lawrence. Oh God, Mario, here they come, all the 1989. Can you react to 1989, please, dude? Yeah, okay, let me breathe a little bit. Okay, it's not just a Taylor Swift video factory over here. We got a lot of artists that we want to talk about. But the lyrics. When you give me love, I feel it, I feel it, I feel it. I ran through the ceiling. No, my life, it never had a meaning. You gave me a reason. You got me believing. You're making me say. Okay, so it's like married man lyrics. Understood. Excited for the album. I'm moving on now into the next tune on the list. We have one from The Weeknd and Ariana Grande. Something about like a bunch of songs being leaked this week on Ariana Grande. A bunch of like old Sweetener songs. I feel like something happened. I've been seeing stuff on Twitter. Y'all fill me in any details that you guys know. But we now have this remix that I believe Ariana just hopped on for Die For You for the week from The Weeknd. Was Die For You from Don FM? For some reason, I don't remember it. I die for you. Or was it on the Metro Boomin? I think it was on the Metro Boomin. Even though we know it. Wait a minute, what? It was on Starboy. Wait, what? Hey, shut up. Don't call me bitch. I'm reading a chat right now. Shut up. Her whole catalog is slowly getting leaked, and I have no idea what's happening. And they're just leaving the scrap songs to be tossed aside. Yeah, what the fuck is going on? Okay, yeah, Die For You is on Starboy. This is... Why the fuck did they just... That's so random. She arranged her part. Yeah, she arranges. I'm pretty sure she arranges all her parts for like everything. But okay, cool. I guess let's throw it back to Starboy with a new Ariana feature. Okay. She's like not going to get on anything on Don FM. She's like, no, sorry. Sorry, Abel. Don't want to do any new songs. But this one's pretty fire, though. Well, I wonder if she was like originally supposed to be maybe like a featured artist, something like that. I don't know. Maybe that's what was happening. Die For You has been in the top list. Yeah, I know it's been on the radio for like fucking ever, dude. I literally just got out of the car and I heard it. So, yeah, I am. Oh, wait, maybe this is the remix. Okay, maybe I should have heard the remix. Okay. You like my Ariana Grande impression? Yeah, no problem. Thanks. Yeah. Yeah. What's up, Abel? Let me hop on this remix of Die For You because you know I would die for you. Dude, Ariana, my Ariana impression is like eerily close to just like ASMR fuckboy. It's near indistinguishable, and I gotta work on it more. So sorry. Let's listen to this music. It's incredible. Yeah, best fucking song of the week. I can already tell. Thank you. that her? Is that Arden just doing whistle notes in the back already?
Find a way to articulate the feeling I'm going through. I just can't say I don't love you. Cause I love you.
I love you too, Abel.
It's hard for me to communicate the thoughts that I hold. But tonight I'm gonna let you know. Let me tell the truth.
Tell me.
Baby, let me tell the truth.
Go ahead.
Yeah. You know what I'm thinking.
What?
See it in your eyes.
Yes.
You hate that you want me. Hate it when you cry. You're scared to be lonely. Especially in the night.
In the night.
I'm scared that I'll miss you. Happens every time. I don't want this feeling. I can't afford love. I try to find reason.
I love this little building, this kick drum up.
It ain't working because you're perfect. And I know that you're worth it. I can't walk away.
It's not enough. It's not enough, actually. You know what, Ariana? Thank you for this, but it's not enough, dude. I need another one. And another one. I need them, dude. I need them. Yeah, that's pretty good, man. That's pretty fucking good. God, she saw those two. Honestly, I don't know why people were so out of pocket. She can't sing anymore just because she hasn't put out an album in a while. It's like, dude, you think these people just like don't sing? Like this super passionate thing that they've built like their whole lives around. They're just like one day like, you know what? I'm not going to sing anymore. That's just not my thing, dude. I'm just not going to do that anymore. Like, dude, she's just chilling. She's living her life, you know? Like, I would rather an artist take a long time to just like live life and to make songs about like what they've currently been going through rather than like force it, squeeze it out of them like the last drops of like a grapefruit or something, you know? Like that's just not, I don't want those low quality songs. I want the long, I want the long shit. So, and plus she's like what, on Broadway or some shit right now? She's fucking killing it, dude. But it is kind of dope that she was like, let me just come back and deliver this for you really quick because I think y'all might have forgotten something. Yeah, Sabrina Carpenter. I'm just kidding. I love Sabrina. I will not pit them against each other. But that was Die For You. And now we have the Halsey song, Die For Me. We're just dying for everybody. You, me, Ariana, The Weeknd, fucking everybody. Everybody's dead. Everybody's deceased. It's all fucking great shit. I mean, I guess so. Maybe. We'll see. We will see. Halsey has kind of been a mixed bag. You know what I mean? So, let's get it, dude. Let's get it. Die For Me. Ooh, minor. Ooh, no, we're going back up. Okay. Said you take a bullet, told me you would die for me. I had a really bad feeling you'd be lying to me. We were on the low, but you were getting high with me. Learned the lesson when you showed a different style. Whoa, wait a minute. Said you die for me, you die for me, you die for me. But whoa. You lied to me, you lied to me, you lied to me. Said you die for me, you die for me, you die for me. But you lied to me, you lied to me, you lied to me. Yeah, okay. I hope you think about me every time you touch it. I hope your new girl hears it and she loves it. That was front door and I'm banging on the line. If I said I don't wanna answer, I'd be lying, yeah. Said you die for me, you die for me, you die for me. But you lied to me, you lied to me, you lied to me. Said you die for me, you die for me, you die for me. But you lied to me, you lied to me, you lied to me. Sorry, I'm tripping right now. I think I might have heard this song before. Is this, has this been out? Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. This is a Post Malone song? She wrote this for Posty? Okay, wait. Yeah, this was on Hollywood's Bleeding. Ah, okay. And she just decided to put it out on her own with her vocals on it? Is it produced by the same people? Hold up. You dive me, you dive me. Did it do well? I don't think I remember it doing super duper well, but yeah, it's kind of more one of the lower mid-range for that album. Show credits. Yeah, Andrew Watt, Lewis Bell. Big producer names. Really big producer names. I was gonna say it kind of feels a little dated with like the trap drums and like all the, like I just felt like I had kind of heard it before. Funny, because I literally had heard it before from the other artist. But yeah, just kind of like a weird re-release for me. Let's finish it up. Yeah, shut up. Said you die for me, you die for me, you die for me. But you lied to me, you lied to me, you lied to me. Said you die for me, you die for me, you die for me. You lied to me, you lied to me, you lied to me. Yeah. Settle down, I'll spell it out, it's simple enough. I came around, I figured I should follow my gut. I don't play anymore. I went through your phone and called the girls in your DMs and took all them home. And I know it's been a while since the last time you heard from me. Going to a savage, you can hear it in this verse, honey. Turns out it shows, cause they turn out it shows. I sold 40 million copies of our paper note. Bought some strangers in on bets and now you lost your right to privacy. Spilling all our secrets, you thought they'd probably die with me. No, you fucking love it on the low. And you don't have to say
say I'm crazy, cause I know nothing's changed.
Said you'd take a bullet, told me you would die for me.
It's a little, you know, peculiar vocal attributes, a little bit, as you know, but you know, hey, she's leaning into it, I guess.
Had a really bad feeling you'd be lying to me. You were in love, but you were getting high with me. Learned a lesson when you showed it.
Oh, it's a TikTok thing. I should have known, dude. I should have known. Should have known it was the damn clock app again. So what? They were like bothering her, people on TikTok, for her verse, and she was just like, yeah, here's just my version. Yeah, it kind of is that like oddly over repetitive. Die for me, die for me, die for me. Said you lie to me, lie to me, lie to me. Yeah.
But you lie to me, you lie to me, you lie to me. Said you die for me, you die for me, you die for me. But you lie to me, you lie to me, you lie to me. Yeah, this is the last time.
Hawkeye MG, we got a local millennial in here. TikTok? Kesha? You must be talking about Kesha. Because nothing else is called TikTok now, right? What the fuck? Of course.
I'ma do you the honor. I'll give you a headline. I know I shouldn't bother. This is a lesson to take. Hold someone tight and they break. Then you say it's a mistake, but you meant it anyway. Now you can blame me. Tell them you made me.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good, though. Thank you, Halsayer. Appreciate that, dude. I need to show you guys some freaking real music, though. So strap the fuck in.
Yeehaw! Let's get it!
Let's go.
Way down in the holler back in Kentucky, catfish on the line, clean it, throw it in the bucket. Come on, yeah, come on,
yeah, come on.
Way up in them diesel, sitting closest to God, ride the bull 8 seconds, pull the gate when you nod. Come on, yeah, come on.
Oh my god! Oh shit! Oh my god! Wait a minute, bro. Hold on. I got. I did not listen to that entire song. Dude, this shit has been going viral as fuck recently, and I have to show you this, dude. I have to. So her name is Katie Noel, and she's this like southern country artist, I guess, but she does a lot of like, it's very much the like boom stomp, almost like grassroots rap country. She's very well known for her rapping in her songs, and it's just kind of taken the world by storm. To me personally, when I saw the video, I thought I was just looking at like a random character generator. Like it had never crossed my mind that somebody that's like, I should just pull the video up and just show you guys what like the actual video, because it's, I mean, honestly, I haven't seen the entire thing, but I want to, and we honestly, as a community, we should do these things together. So here we go, dude. Katie Noel, Southern.
Let's go.
Get on your tractor.
Down in the holler back in Kentucky, catfish on the line.
Oh my god, I'm sorry. Hold on. I need to see how far up that hat is.
Way down in the holler back in Kentucky, catfish.
Oh my god. I haven't seen somebody wear a hat like that in almost 10 years. Like, that's like just the like the barely on.
Fish on the line, clean it, throw it in the bucket, come on.
Okay. Yeah,
come on.
Come on, y'all.
Way
come on.
Up in them days, we're sitting closest to God, right before they
oh my God. It's like she hits every like perfect Southern like little tag. Like it's like almost like, I don't know if you guys have seen the Bo Burnham special of pandering, but like it's wild, wild how accurate that is when you listen to a song like this, because she mentions like every single pandery Southern thing. And you know what? It's kind of impressive.
Way up in them days, we're sitting closest to God. Right before 8 seconds, pull the gate when you nod. Come on. Yeah, come on.
What is this?
Surviving, we live it. Stealing hearts with a shit-eating grin.
Did she say stealing hearts with a shit-eating grin? What is a shit-eating grin? Like, there's so many. Like, I am Southern. Like, I was born and raised in the South. Shit, I'm more Southern than her, technically. She's in Kentucky. I'm in Georgia. So, I never heard a shit-eating grin, bro. There's so many, like, little phrases in here that I'm so unfamiliar with. The K has subscribed. Thank you so much, man. Rides a horse one time. Exactly. That's me right now. See, I'm just trying to learn about the culture, dude. I'm trying to ride my
we live it, stealing hearts with a shit.
This is my culture, bro. Besides, like, her rapping, because that's clearly not.
Getting granted, fried chicken, cat head biscuits, summertime cold beer sweet.
Fried chicken. Like, bro. Tell me you, like, I've never seen a flavor of lesbian like this. Like, I've never in my life.
Smoke brisket down home sexy, yeah, we know it. Fresh pig, sweet corn, baby, we grow it. Redneck backwoods covered in shit, got some
Redneck backwards covered in shit. Oh, my God. Wow. I just love, like, the confidence of the vibrato. She's like, yeah, we're covered in shit. And we're proud of it, Southern Bells. Shit-eating, talking. There's shit everywhere. There's shit in her mouth. There's shit all over her body. Shit all over her trunk. What's this obsession with shit?
Hang with my twang in the grip, cause I'm Southern.
Dude, homie back here in the yellow shirt is like, this is my fucking music video. Watch him. Look at this shit. He eyeing that shit. He eyeing the camera straight up. He said, it's my motherfucking song, bitch.
Slide jaw full of outlaw. Have you feeling all right? Scuffs on my beans. Wearing these jeans.
Scuffs on my beans? Bean? Oh, LL Bean? Wait, what?
Roadside, go balls, SCC. Smoking, drinking, fighting, riding, races, trackers, hard to straighten. Southern Bells sit right beside us. Damn good day when the fish are biting. Top of water, sinking bobbers. I get these looks from my mama, kick ass from my father. Come on, surviving, we live it. Stealing hearts with a shitting grin.
I know the moves. I know the moves. I hate this. Like, bro, I learned. I watch this. I bring this up ironically. Why am I?
Head biscuits, summertime cold beer, sweet smoke brisket, down home sexy. Yeah, we know with fresh pig, sweet corn, baby, we grow with redneck backwoods covered shit. Got some bang in my twang.
I think she might be saying tougher than shit, but I like to imagine that she's talking about being covered in shit.
With some grit. D-O-W-N-S-O-U-T-H for the win.
Oh my God, she's spelling it. You know what though? that's impressive in some southern areas. You know, if you can spell the entire word without messing up one time, fucking good job, man.
Down south, uh-huh.
Dude, this is so fucking funny that, like, honestly, first of all, thick thighs save lives, and he's hanging off like a like probably one of the most lesbian people I've ever seen. So funny to me. And it's like it's a perfect role reversal. It's actually kind of beautiful in a way. In a way.
That is where I reside, Carolina, Tennessee, Kentucky, till I die.
Got a 606 and a 615, got the 808 and the 865, got the 706 sitting right beside me with my Knox County boys pulling up behind me, bitch.
Surviving, we live it, stealing hearts with a shitting grinning, fried chicken, cat head biscuits, summertime cold beer, sweet smoke brisket, down home.
And you know they had to pick straws. They're like, all right, we need to throw somebody in the mud. Who's it going to be? Ah, shit. God damn it. You're not throwing me in there. He saw the first guy, and he was like, nah, you're going to have to fucking do it to me for real. They threw his ass back in there. He's like, yeah, but fuck you.
I'm Southern.
So I'm Southern. You know what? That's right. They want to be covered in mud. They actually like being covered in shit. I forgot. Thank you for reminding me. Honestly, though, I feel like I shit on that. But at the same time, it's stuck in my fucking head, dude. God damn it, bro. I haven't been able to not see it on my Twitter timeline, but oh, God, dude. Yeah, the lyrics are kind of just like super pandery. The beat and the production isn't bad. And the little chorus moment. Bow down, bow down, bow down, bow down. It's country. I guess it's country. I guess so, dude. Anyways. What's next? What do we have? What else do we have on the list other than Southern? We got my buddy Adam's song, or his name is Stecker. I did want to listen to this if you guys are down. I'm just going to listen to it because I feel like he might have shown me this. It's called The Best I Can Do. So this is The Best He Can Do. This is his top tier song. This is the best ever that he's produced. Not topping this one after this song. Even if it's a better song, this one is literally the best I can do. So here we go.
I don't know if I can, but I'll try.
I just wanna hide and it sounds scary, but you always find your way back in. And I told you I never wanted to see you, but I kinda hope we meet in person. I imagine it as brief, something where we nod and walk on by. But I'd be lying if I didn't wanna ask if you're alright. And I know I'll never get the chance again.
I like that piano coming in. The auto-tune vocals sound a little...
And I know get to call you friend. No. And I'll never feel good by the end.
It is kind of crunchy.
I can just hope you find me found rest.
Ooh, that's nice. I like that.
But the best I can do is write you down.
Yeah, it is.
I know I shouldn't look back, but I just can't seem to fight the urge.
I like the production, though.
You told me to just take care of myself, but I think I made things worse. Cause I'm the one that left. You said that's for the best.
Okay, the beat, though.
You're not here, it's one of my biggest regrets.
Yes, sir. Yes, this spice. Yeah, this feels like a fucking Disney movie right here.
But the best I can do is write you down and let you go.
I like the Decker.
And you'll never feel good about the end.
Yeah, I really fuck with the chorus.
Rest, but the best I can do will never be good enough.
You just kind of have to keep going.
Okay, I see with the little motivational moments in the beginning and the end. Very cool. I feel like the autotune is cool because obviously, like, with this style of, like, music, there's gonna be, like, electronic flair going on. I feel like sometimes it does kind of, like, waver on the side of, like, maybe could be tighter. But other than that, all the melodies feel really fucking good once you get into that drop. It just takes me, like, a second. It's almost like they had me in the first half kind of bit. But yeah, that's Stecker. Check him out, dude. He's in the chat right now, I'm pretty sure. So, Adam, feel free to plug yourself. And go stream him, dude. Fucking check him out, bro. He's a homie. He's got some great fucking tunes in there. I think, hold on, let me recommend. Personally, I would recommend High Note and Stand Still. Those are two of my faves that I know for a fact that I've listened to and enjoyed. So, check the boy out. But somebody said pretty much, though, when they're all independent. Hold on. Pretty much is independent now? Interesting. Interesting. Ascended on a high note. Always looking my own, even all in my note. Doing a bright note on my high note. Good riddance. I'm gonna be honest with you, man. I have only been seeing sad ass memes, and I am not in a sad mood. And I feel like in order to appreciate the sadness of that music, I need to be a little sad. I need to channel my inner sad boy. I haven't been like that. I've been good. So when I feel the self-deprecation coming on of, like, listening to sad music when you're already sad, I'll probably check it out. Caroline Polachek is absolutely fucking coming. You betch your big, juicy, voluptuous, fat ass, all right? It's coming. I think we might have one or two more for this last stream, though. My buddy Matt Walden, a streamer here on Twitch as well that you might be familiar with. He reached his goal of 1,000 pre-saves, so he's dropping a new album. This song is what he's been promoting for, like, the last, like, what, month or so? Maybe I'm the problem? Dude, this one, tearjerker. Let me be honest with you. I will end it as a sign of respect for the man. But I probably will not be crying because, I don't know, I'll be cracking jokes or something, dude. I don't know, something. But y'all will probably fuck with it. Before we do get into this one, though, I'll take another moment just to say that Reputation is up on Patreon right now. If you are here and you're like, where the fuck is Taylor Swift, Troy? What the fuck? What are you doing, huh? You just fucking with us? You're just screwing with us? The answer is yes, always and forever. But it is up on Patreon right now, and it will be coming to YouTube this weekend. So, check it out. You can subscribe. It's going to be an interesting time. Reputation is like a mixed bag for me. There are songs that I like really enjoyed where I was like, wow, this is some good Taylor Swift. You know what I mean? And then there's some other ones that I was like, oh shit, that's some bad Taylor Swift. So yeah, it'll be kind of a roller coaster of a video. Kind of almost like, I don't know, a little bit of Lover, kind of a little bit like the Lover reaction, but I don't know. I'm not going to tell you if I liked it more or less than Lover, but I'll leave it up to you. Coffee Jelly has already seen it, clearly. Talking about the edits, thank you very much. Made those myself. That was a Troy edit. And I believe the Paramore, This Is Why, is also going to be coming out this next week, so that'll be fun too. So looking forward to both of those. Let's get into this last tune from Mr. Matt, bro. Beautiful piano.
Wish I didn't have to move away from the place we built a home, 'cause I just loved what we had.
Oh, a low voice moment.
Used to always let you decorate, 'cause you said it brought you joy, but now the walls are plain and sad.
Oh, no.
Sorry I didn't say it sooner.
There's nothing sadder than white walls, dude.
I'm so fucked up in my head. No.
No, no, you're not. No, Matt, no.
Maybe I'm the problem. If only that's the reason. Maybe if I change the way I am.
The chorus does slightly resemble Greatest Showman. But we've already, I talked about that. Dude, Matt was so worried when he first showed me this song, bro. He was like, dude, people are going to say, people are going to think I copied it. And honestly, it does kind of sound like it a little bit. But it doesn't sound close enough where it's like verbatim. So I think he's in the good. I think he's in the good. He's in the clear.
Happy. If only I could go back to that day. It was only yesterday. Only yesterday. Only. A year ago I planned a trip. Your family thought it would be it. I would put a ring on your hand.
Subbing in that bass for that low piano.
I always knew you were the one. Waited too long and now you're gone. I'll never forgive myself for the way.
Yeah, this is still sad, but I've heard it before. So I'm not, it's not gonna get me. It's okay. I'm strong. I'm a strong guy.
Sorry if I hurt you that way. I'm so sorry if I hurt you today. But maybe I'm the problem. If only that's the reason. Maybe if I change the way I am.
Matt's got such a way with his pen game, bro.
Then will you still love me? Maybe we'd be happy. If only
Stop
I could
it.
Go back to that day. It was only yesterday.
I'm good.
Only yesterday.
I said I'm fine.
Oh, it was only yesterday. Oh, it was only yesterday.
I'm fine. I said, I'm fine. Sophie, you son of a bitch. No tears have fallen. Okay, they might have been watering up slightly. The water levels may have rose. prematurely, but they're going down. They're simmering down. See? You saw nothing. Exactly. You saw nothing. You saw nothing. You saw nothing at all, you son of a bitch. Maybe we'll do one, Gracie. If there was a song from the new album that you would have me listen to, what would it be, Chad? Just one. Just a slight one, potentially. Maybe. Maybe. Oh. 12 songs. It's not too long. It's not too bad. Might be doable. I don't know. The Blue? The Blue? Okay, we're listening to The Blue. I'm a big fan of The Blue. I like a good blue. I like a good navy, you know? Maybe a nice chartreuse. I could get down.
You live in Hollywood. You're half an hour from me. Your reputation's good. I hope you've got a lot in common.
Reputation?
I kind of think you should just drop it all and call me. You tell me on the phone you really want to meet my family. What?
It is a little bit of cursive singing, a little bit. It is giving a little avocados.
You talk about your dad. He used to get so angry. He'd scare you and your brother till you felt you needed saving.
Oh, God.
I know I'd let you in.
Who produced?
On all my bad decisions, you'd make.
You can tell his guitar. It's the little plucky, the high plucky melodies. That's very Aaron. That's very Aaron. Yeah.
If you can tell I'm losing, I'm going down without a fight. I don't know how you do it.
Oh, man.
You say we share a brain, apologizing for
that must be complicated.
But take it as a compliment.
A subtle synth kind of creeping in. Subtle fuzzy synth.
Oh.
I love the little sprinkles of production in here. Aaron is so tasteful with that shit, bro.
What are you doing to me now? What are you doing to me?
great progression. I love the leading low notes on the guitar. The song is 5 minutes long. Came out of the blue like that. I never could have seen you coming. I think you're everything I wanted. You came out of the blue like that. You came out of the blue like that. I never could have seen you coming. I think you're everything I've wanted. You came out of the blue like that. You came out of the blue. Little violin creeping in there at the last second is super sweet. This would be a really interesting album because personally, I feel like I haven't heard a whole lot of Gracie. I know that a lot of people hype her up in the same way that I feel like you guys hype up like Maisie Peters, almost in the same way that like people are starting to hype up Lizzie McAlpine, you know, or well, not really. People have been hyping up Lizzie. She's now just kind of getting, in my opinion, notoriety. But I feel like when it comes to an album, it's going to be really showing to see her lyricism because Aaron does a really, really good way of getting out of the way and like enhancing the energy. So I really wonder how she's going to convey what she's going to be talking about throughout the entire album. It is the kind of vocal fry that I'm not like a super big fan of. It definitely does kind of sound like cursive singing, like I feel like somebody said before. But it's not impossible to get through. I just kind of don't feel super strongly in either direction when it comes to Gracie Abrams. I feel like she has yet to prove herself a worthy artist of following. As fucking stupid as that sounds, but honestly, it's kind of just like, okay, well, that's kind of fine, I guess. Speaking of Lizzie McAlpine, though, you wanted tears, so I might as well give it to you because we're going to be watching the Ceilings music video right now. I'm going to end stream with it. So this is going to be torture. I haven't seen it, but today will be a first. So I guess here we go. Yeah. Fun. Let's have pain. Oh God, we're at a party. Oh, the anxiety's starting. Fuck. Oh God. Okay. Okay, we got some cuties in there. We got some. Ooh. Okay, hello. Oh.
Ceilings.
Oh.
Plastic.
There she is.
Can't you just make it move faster?
Aww.
Lovely to be sitting here with you.
Oh my God, the film look, the cinematicness.
Cute, but it's raining.
They're both kind of cute. They're both really cute.
Harder. My shoes are now full of water.
Dude, why is she such an actress, bro?
To be rained on.
First the whole the 5 seconds flat
it's
documentary,
cute,
now this.
But it's so short, then you're driving me home, and I don't wanna leave, but I have to go. You kiss me in your car, and it feels like the start of a movie I've seen
yes.
before.
He's the blueprint. Oh.
Before.
Makes me so happy seeing Lizzie happy, bro. What the fuck?
Benchings,
oh, it's dark.
No clothes. Touch me like nobody else does. Lovely to just lay here with you.
Ah!
You're kind of cute, and I would say all of this
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Hi, okay.
What's up? This is Lizzie.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
No.
The cut to when she's just fucking alone. But it's not real. And you don't exist. Fuck me. Oh my god, Lizzie. What the fuck? Honestly, though, I can't see anything anyway, so I might as well just close my eyes. I'm just really glad that Lizzie has been able to, like, blow up with this song on TikTok. I've been seeing all the, like, the chipmunk versions of it. Really cool. Really, really cool. She deserves it so much. She's such an incredible artist. I feel like she's just doing it better than so many others are. And I just feel like, you know, from the multiple artists that have been birthed from Folklore and Evermore, or just from this whole, like, resurgence of, like, true singer-songwriters in their bag with productions and lyrics and songwriting and everything, she just stands at the top of them. And, she really just really is the pinnacle. So I am a Lizzie McAlpine stan. She took my eyes from me. I don't care. It doesn't matter, dude. I have my ears, bro. That's all that matters. I don't care about my eyes. Whatever, dude. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. I can't.
Oh, hell no!
Nope. I don't know. Let me get this. I can see again. The tears. They've parted ways. Like Moses parting the sea. God, it looks so good. It's such like a cinematic quality. Like, dude, the cinematic quality is crazy. What is this Bruises songs you're talking about? God, man. Oh, dude. Oh, it's a new Renee rap song? Is it just one extra song? Oh, thank you. Appreciate that. It's purple. It's a purple beanie, but I'll take pink. It's okay. Two extra songs. Everything to Everyone as well. It's pink. Fuck it. It's pink. I don't care. It's bubblegum pink. Oh, that's bad. That's not a good. That's not a good thing. Okay, so what? Bruises, Renee Rapp. Very new. Okay, 5 hours ago? Bet. Trigger warning. Some blood, knives, and violent imagery. A metaphorical story about how words hurt. Love you all. Take care of each other. Okay. Roger. Bruises.
And like, I don't think Confusion, like, seriously.
Wait, why is this in like 360p? Are you fucking serious right now? I'm gonna chuck my computer across the goddamn room. 360p is what YouTube thought they could give me. I am a 1080p 4K bitch. Let's go.
Like, I don't think Confusion, like, seriously warrants that, right? And I don't know.
Okay.
She's a bitch.
It's oh. Like,
my fault.
Just cut out the victim complex, start being a little bit more honest, and it might work better for you.
Oh, okay. Shit.
Bye.
Damn. Yeah, that is so unrealistic as fuck. Dude, I have never met somebody who's been able to just speak up like that.
It's like not my fault.
Just cut out the victim complex, start being a little bit more honest. And...
just cut the victim complex and start being a little bit more honest, bitch.
Might work better for you.
Damn.
Okay.
Bye. She's like, this fucking bitch. Fuck her too. Oh, ow. Oh, what the fuck? Wait a fucking second. I was about to say, she better, that shit hurt. God damn. Oh, shit. She just straight up. That's a rough jump cut, though, but damn. Yeah. Shit. She's like, okay, what do you do now? Damn. So wait. She's saying that she was stabbed because somebody was like, stop being mean? I don't know. What was this whole conversation? I kind of missed this whole like back end of the conversation. I need to listen better.
And like, I don't think confusion like seriously warrants that, right?
I don't really think there needs to be any more of that.
And I don't know. She's a bitch.
She's just a bitch.
It's like not my fault.
Just cut out the victim complex, start being a little bit more honest, and it might work better for you.
Okay.
Bye. Damn, that should look kind of crazy good though too. Oh my god.
I spent Ooh. 22 years of my life trying not to freak out, trying not to be needy.
Okay.
I go through six different notes.
I mean, I would be looking at somebody too if they had a knife sticking out of them.
In my mind. Quick transitions are crazy. It's not fair. I've got acetone for veins.
Ooh, I'm so acetone for veins.
Just one touch and I feel pain. All my friends make sweet fun of me. I guess it's funny, but the truth's I bruise easily. And oh. Sure, I'm down to be the joke. Metaphorically, though, you could flip me inside out and they would show. Black, purple, and green. Yeah, I bruise easily. I spent.
Oh, damn. Wait, how the fuck? Wait, oh my god. Oh, and the drums are coming in now? Hold on a second. Wait, where do these knives come from, though?
Down to be the joke. Spent 365 days and 52 weeks in my brain.
This is a really cool music video to film. It's kind of like low concept, low budget, but it really gets the point across. It's my favorite kind of music video.
Going over the same thing that God said when we was in fourth grade. I take everything.
I love how casual she is too, with just like three knives sticking out of her chest. Like nobody will be that that cash. Oh, that's all right. I'm just bleeding to death. No problem here. It's all right. I'm chilling, bro. Yeah, I'm gonna grab a corn dog on the side of the street.
Personally, I've always hated that about me.
Ah, what the fuck?
I've tried to be cool and chill, but it's not fair. I've got acetone for veins.
Oh, here we go. The sponsored segment. This video is brought to you by Olipop, guys.
I'm so sensitive. Just one touch and I feel pain.
All my friends, man. Damn, who threw that shit? Honestly, they kind of had crazy aim game.
Makes sweet fun of me. I guess it's fun.
Oh shit, she gonna shoot a shotgun at
it. But the truth's I bruise easily.
She's one of the boys. Wait. I'm losing it at the fact that like everybody has a knife and they're just like at the smallest convenience. Hey! I mean, maybe like watch where you're stepping to. I don't know. I mean, you're in the city. You're on the sidewalk. for Jesus Christ, people shit on the sidewalk. You don't see people just stepping in shit randomly. Watch out where you're going. Okay.
Please don't fucking swing. It hurts me.
Friends make sweet fun of me.
I'm sorry. Using the knife as a point of connection for the eyeliner is like the most slay thing I think I've seen all week. That's insane. Oh my god, that's the move. What the fuck was Conan Gray doing there? Dude. Conan Gray, what the fuck are you doing? Go hang out with Olivia, bro. Oh, damn. Killer Bee Plant. Oh, there's two. Oh, two sponsors. All right. Killer Bee? Dude, what the fuck? A Naruto reference for Killer Bee also? What the fuck? Okay, hell yeah. Nice.
No, like, I'm not joking.
But specifically vegan. I was a vegan for 2 years.
Uh-huh. Only 2 years.
Hell yeah. Shout out. I love that they do this. Dude, I just learned that apparently in like Japan, when you go to a movie theater and you go and see a movie, in a movie theater where you go and see movies, they don't like get up when the credits start rolling. Like they actually stay for all of them. All of them. And I honestly fuck with that. I used to do that in college all the time. Because it was like, yeah, you respect everybody who watches it, you know? And hell yeah. I know it's not Conan Gray. I'm just joking, okay? Every boy with like black, long, curly hair is Conan Gray to me, all right? So you're just going to see a movie at the movie theater on movie day to go see a movie? Damn, that's crazy. Okay, anyways, that is the stream, folks, today. Hope you had a good time. Thanks for tuning in. I am excited to see what you guys will all think of Reputation when it drops this weekend. And yeah, it's been fun. Thanks for hanging, man. Is anybody streaming now that maybe we could potentially raid? I don't know. If I can spell Twitch correctly, maybe I can find out. Hey, Ernie. Hell yeah, I'll do Ernie. He's listening to the new Logic album. And I was listening to a little bit of it before stream started, and it was pretty fucking good, dude. Oh, wait, is it B-Real time? Wait, is it fucking B-Real? Hold up. This is serious. Honest, serious question. It is. All right. You guys ready? Boom. You're all there, baby. I know I'm late. I know I'm late, dude. But honestly, I'm pretty fucking good, bro, at B-Real. Like, I take that shit pretty fucking seriously, to be honest with you. Yes, Phoebe. You all look fantastic. All right, mod block Ian. Never funnier than me. Don't know why he keeps on doing that. Stop being funnier than me, bro. Okay, dude. The third Ernie's. We're gonna raid the man. Shouts out to the boy. And I guess I'll, fuck, man. I want to say see you tomorrow so badly, but I just don't know if I'm going to be up for it. But honestly, though, I need to be up for it because I need to send it to Star so that she can start editing the Caroline Polachek so I have a video for the first of the months. So thank you again for showing me Caroline Polachek. We got to check that shit out. What time tomorrow? I'll tell you what time on my Instagram story. So just keep an eye out for that shit. Other than that, though, as always, stay happy, healthy, and strong. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace! Good stream!